serious. Okay. 0-0. Gatien to serve. I have to say that Jorgen looks really hot tonight.
Yeah, he's running after the ball and yeah.
Aggressive.
Focused. So.
There was the old Filou.
Yeah.
There with his forehand, very quick. Oh, very nice backhand.
I think many of the players is serving half long or long many times, and this is I think it's normal when you don't play that many,
mm-hmm.
when you don't practice that much and you don't play so many games, that the service and receives is not as good as it used to be.
It's really difficult to keep up if you haven't practiced, as you say, so you can see the difference from the ones that are still active and the ones that are not.
Yeah, yeah.
Jorgen is now up 4-3. Four in net out and 4-4. And the statistics between these two players, take on?
Don't ask me these difficult questions all the time. but of course, it's the same here that they have been playing many, many times, because France and Sweden was, yeah, two of the best teams in the world for a long time, in especially in Europe. So many, many matches, team matches against each other. And then also, of course, in the singles tournament, two of the best players in the world that mm-hmm. time. So, but it's right against left again, just like in the first match. And Jorgen is comfortable playing against left-handed
mm-hmm.
because he have a very good defense with his backhand side. And that is important against left. As a right-hander.
Oh. Very nice forehand from Jean-Philippe Gatien. Former world champion from 1993, which actually was in Gothenburg, Sweden. So he likes to be here in Sweden, I guess. Also silver medalist in the Olympics, Barcelona, 1992.
Yeah.
Where he lost against John Ove Waldner.
Was very strong during these years, 92, 93, mm-hmm. 94. 94, they won the team European Championships, France, and so he's he was very dominating the sport in these years.
Extremely fast player with a very nice footwork and with a great forehand. The backhand has never been his strong side, though. Oh, good serve and good forehand. But on the other hand, he was fast enough to play forehand almost all over the table.
Yeah.
Persson in the lead, 9-7. And I would say that the same goes for this match. The first set is important.
Yeah. Some mistakes on his own service here in this set.
Mm-hmm.
And he's down 8-10. I think he made two mistakes on his own serve. So, fatal mistakes.
Two set points for Jorgen Persson. Saves the first one, gets in. So now it's 10-9. Persson's got one more serve here. Jorgen Persson takes the first set, 11-9.
Filou is very aggressive in his receive, taking the ball very early, and the ball is coming very fast for the opponent. And Danny is trying to follow up with the aggressive shot after the receive. It's a very good tactic, but also a very, very difficult tactic, because it's small margins, you know, to handle this. And
mm-hmm. Now the commentator is also presenting another legend, Ulf Bengtsson, European champion from 1984. He's in the crowd here.
Det låter ju väldigt intressant och där kommer ett smil också. Tingis idag, har det förändrats mycket tycker du sen du spelade 1984?
Alltså det går mycket snabbare, alltså. Men tankemässigt tror jag att vi var ganska bra på den tiden, det tror jag.
Men det är rätt så härligt att se det här gänget och vilken imponerande samling. Ambassadörer för vår sport.
The players are waiting for the interview with Ulf Bengtsson to be complete.
Tack till Ulf Bengtsson, en av våra hjältar, och till Sven här ikväll. Då kör vi igång.
Second set, person to serve. Flick just outside. Person got directly, 1 point directly on serve.
In his old days, he would have played forehand on that ball.
Yeah.
Filou.
Oh, Jorgen tries to chop the ball to the table.
Very impressed by Jürgen's backhand, very wide out to the forehand. Also
plays
in his
really
first game against Rossi, he made the same many times. So his backhand is working well today, even if he made a mistake there.
Yes. He's twisting his back. That was also a bit of a trademark for Gatien in his old days, bending his back and playing forehand. Getting a bit more aggressive in this set, and now he leads 5-4.
If he can receive good against Jorgen, he can have a little chance. But it's very risky when he receives.
Very nice flick from Jorgen. Five five. Got chance to serve. Oops. Wasn't really happy with that miss there.
Tried a quick, fast serve, but unfortunately a mistake.
Good receive by Jorgen. He seems to be having his game together. And all parts of the game is very good.
Yeah.
Good attacks are good, and his defense is perfect. And the backhand has given him a lot of points this evening.
Yeah. And also I feel he's very positive and looking hot.
Yeah, running after the ball, and I think he will be a dangerous opponent for all of the players tonight. Oh. Gatien turned that ball around, and now he is down 6-8. Very nice forehand by Gatien there, 8-7, 7-8.
Quick serve, and Jorgen is receiving not that strong, and then he is coming very aggressive on the next point. Very good tactic and trademark for Filou.
Yeah. 9-7 to Jorgen.
Filou was expecting a cross backhand.
And he played down the line.
Yeah.
Very nice.
He was not so happy because his back was aching.
But he still looks kind of fit, I have to say.
Yeah. They all do.
Mm-hmm.
All players.
Gatien, born 1969. And Persson, 1966. Nine all. It's a very important set this for the rest of the match. I would say, Gatien would probably need to win this to stay in the game, because to be down 2-0 against Jorgen, it's really tough for him. I think. Unfortunately, now for Gatien, Jorgen Persson now has his first set point in the second set, 10-9.
Oh yeah, very strong forehand coming around the back and corner and playing down the line with his forehand. Very impressive. Very quick receive by Filou.
Oh, again. Oh, very nice forehand.
Because of the aggressive receive from Filou, it's very difficult for Jorgen to do anything better than that. And then he killed the ball. So impressive. And set point.
Ooh. Edge ball from Gatien, which gives him 12 points to 10. And 1-1 in sets. So he's far away from out of this tournament, Gatien.
Two close sets, 11-9 and 12-10, so tight match.
Persson now talks to Waldner about tactics. I don't know if they're planning to be finalists tonight.
They are trying to...
That would be
maybe make this a Swedish final tonight.
Swedish final tonight. But there is also one big obstacle before that will take place and happen. And that obstacle is called Jean-Michel Save, which perhaps is the most fit player here tonight.
But also we must say that Filou is also an obstacle because
he's
1-1 in this
far
game.
Away, far so away from outcome. Yeah. So we'll see. A bit of a dark horse here tonight because nobody really knew his shape. Now he's getting better and better now, even scoring with his backhand.
And also his game is so quick and so difficult for the opponent. So if he can play 100% here, he's dangerous for everybody.
Mm-hmm. Oh, fantastic backhand.
It's a beautiful shot when he is coming from forehand to backhand and the ball is a little short.
Mm-hmm.
This is his best ball and it's the best in the world on this ball.
Well, not that many other players who uses the backhand smash like Persson does.
No.
Most the game today consists of top spins from both backhand and forehand on almost every ball.
Of course, the game was a little different in when Jorgen came up, so it was more smash that time, and backhand smash was his strongest shot.
But I think he has adapted pretty well to the game that 2015 game, and that's really really impressive to stay in the top that long. I mean, it's 30 years.
Yeah, that's what makes these guys legends, that they have been in the top for such a long time, and probably Jorgen and Sev the longest of these guys, because there has been so many different players along them, you know, different generations of players, and also the game has changed a lot through all these years. So to adapt, like you said before, to new techniques and new material. All of this is very impressive by these guys.
Persson up 6-5.
I think Filou is playing better and better. Mm-hmm. So it's. I didn't think this before.
No.
But now he shows.
As I said, he is the dark horse. Nobody really knew how his shape, in what shape he was in, he would be in. And this will not be an easy win for Jorgen, that's for sure. Persson is now up and in the lead, 8-5, and Gatien to serve. Eight six, a bit frustrated there, Jorgen, to miss that backhand. Now he's got two serves. Long, fast serve, which gave him a point directly, 9-6. And 10-6, he's got now four set points. Eleven-6. Persson takes the lead, and now is up 2-1. Which means he needs only one more set to be through to the final.
Was quite aggressive here in the end of this set, mm-hmm. coming, starting with his forehand and putting some pressure on Filou, which missed some blocks and then tried to go back. But impressive end of the set from Jorgen.
We'll see what Filou can come up with in the fourth set here, which he needs to win to stay in the game. We were talking about long successful careers, and Persson is actually one out of three players in the world who participated in all of the Olympic Games where table tennis has been scored.
Seven.
Is it seven or is it six?
Seven.
Seven consecutive Olympic Games. It started in 1988 in Seoul, South Korea. And together with Jean-Michel Save and the Croatian player Zoran Primorac.
Yeah.
And we've heard that Mr. Save has got some plans for competing in Rio 2016, which will make him the number one.
He's still out there competing, mm-hmm. at the World Tour, yeah. But of course it's difficult to qualify. It's via ranking or via the qualification tournament, and
they're quite tough, right?
Yeah, it's tough, mm-hmm. to reach a place, but of course it's a target for Jamie.
Persson looking really sharp here, 2-2.
Keeping the ball in Filou's backhand all the, mm-hmm. time. Pushing Filou to play more aggressive with the backhand.
Real. Very nice forehand down the line by Jorgen Persson now. Gives him 4 points to 3 in the fourth set. And this is the first semi-final, the 2015 ITTF Legends Tour. Good topspin there by Filou, and now it's 4-4 for all. Oh, nice shot there by Jorgen.
Like a tennis match.
Yeah. And here we got some new ball problems, or oh, it looks like it could take Persson smash there. Didn't break. 6-4. It's a good forehand there by Jorgen, even though the receive was quite strong from Gatien. Receives very, very good tonight, Persson, so gives him 7-4, and now he's getting closer to the final. Oh, that did it for the ball, that backhand block, perhaps.
That's a common problem today with the new...
With the plastic ball.
With the new,
yeah.
New plastic ball, that it breaks very easy, and for sure this is something ITTF have to look into very seriously, because it's not good for the sport.
No.
Now they agree, have a new ball.
Yep, 7-4, Persson is in the lead, Gatien serve. Net. Very aggressive there, but I guess.
When the receive is just a little high, Filou is there, very quick, and attacks. So it's very important for Jorgen to keep the receives low or short.
Eight-five to Jorgen, and he's getting closer and closer here. Only 3 points away from the finals. 9-5. Persson is playing high balls. Wasn't really happy with that one, because he was looking forward to a long rally there, I guess.
Is that some bad Swedish word?
Yeah.
We should not translate here.
We'll skip that. Oh, very nice. Ah. Four match points to Jorgen Persson.
Some show here in the end. And the timeout from Filou.
Oh, it takes the timeout now. Four match points. I'm dead, he said. There's a lot of talk here in the comments field about the most successful player among the legends here, and we can say that together they have 18 world championship titles, both team mix doubles and singles. 10-6 for Jorgen, match point. Persson is out of the field, playing field. Whoa! Very nice.
He was out and now he's in again.
He's out and now he's in. Oh, Gatien in there.
What a fantastic rally to end the match.
And Persson is in the final on the 2015 ITTF Legends Tour. crowd is getting excited here in Halmstad. This last ball, last rally, and Jorgen as a winner.
Very nice game.
Very impressed to see Philou playing